Come dicevo, un grande benvenuto a tutti. Per noi è una serata molto importante. È la prima volta della Formula E a Roma. La Formula E che è stata la competizione in cui Jaguar era entrata già nel 2016, prima tra tutti i premium brand, che a partecipare a questo campionato che è destinato, dedicato alle vetture totalmente elettriche. Ma è anche per noi l'anteprima nazionale di una nuova Jaguar, la Jaguar I-Pace, che è una vettura al 100% elettrica, che è stata presentata al Salone di Ginevra e che ha la sua anteprima nazionale qui in Italia oggi. L'I-Pace ha la trazione integrale con due motori sui due assali per un totale di 400 cavalli e avrà un'autonomia di 480 km grazie a una batteria al litio da 90 kW che con la corrente continua si può ricaricare fino all'80% in 40 minuti. È quindi per noi un momento di grande evoluzione del nostro marchio, un grande salto nel futuro che crea una nuova visione e una nuova cultura del mondo automotive. La missione di Panasonic Jaguar Racing è non solo di sviluppare vetture elettriche, di cui I-Pace è solo la prima, ma anche è quello di ispirare e coinvolgere nuove generazioni, quindi giovani, che si accingono a costruire il nostro futuro. Per suggellare questo momento di elettrificazione, questa tappa romana della Formula E, Jaguar Land Rover Italia ha lanciato un'iniziativa con i tre Atenei romani e in particolare con i dipartimenti di ingegneria della Sapienza, di Tor Vergata e di Roma 3. Nasce il progetto Jaguar eFuture Academy, una collaborazione tra le tre università per istituire delle borse di studio Jaguar per gli studenti di ingegneria sul tema della mobilità elettrica e delle tecnologie di elettrificazione dei sistemi di propulsione. Nel percorso formativo rientrano anche alcuni seminari con ingegneri di Jaguar Land Rover Group per approfondire un tema così attuale e rivoluzionario per il nostro settore. Ricordo una frase che dice: il miglior modo per predire il futuro è inventarlo. Ed è proprio per questo che vogliamo coinvolgere pienamente i giovani, per essere loro gli artefici di questo grande cambiamento epocale. Prima di lasciarvi alla serata, volevo farvi vedere come i nostri due piloti, Mitch e Nelson, ieri si siano trasformati in studenti universitari. Prego. Driver, broadcaster and motoring journalist, Amanda.
Buonasera a tutti e benvenuti a Rick Judge. And now I'm also going to carry on in English. So on behalf of everybody at the Panasonic Jaguar Racing Team, I'll stand up, it's easier. On behalf of everybody in the team, thank you very much for welcoming us here in Rome. We are delighted to be here. Now, earlier on, we paid a visit to Rome, so let's take a little look at what you can expect to see tomorrow.
What splendid stuff from PK!
Immensely excited to be here, and so I would like to start off by inviting James Barclay, our team director, onto the stage to talk to us. So James, here in Rome, it's tremendously exciting, as I say, for all of us. What have your impressions been so far?
Yeah, well, firstly, welcome. Thank you, everybody, for joining us tonight. It's fantastic to have such an amazing turnout. I'd also like to thank our team partners. We have representatives from Panasonic, from Fiesman and from GKN tonight, so it's fantastic to have those partners with us this evening, thank you. Well, yeah, firstly, I mean, what an amazing place to have a motor race. The last motor race in the centre of Rome, I think, took place in the Colosseum, so it's pretty spectacular. We're here with this incredible new technology, really pioneering and having a great motor race tomorrow, I'm sure, in Rome. It's really spectacular.
Now, of course, we've had Shakedown already. Just talk to us a little bit about how that's gone and what your impressions of the circuit have been.
Yeah, I mean, what immediately we saw with the circuit layout here is a huge amount of gradients, and the circuit looks like it's going to create some amazing racing. A lot of gradient, a lot of really challenging corners. In fact, after Shakedown, we were actually third and fourth in Shakedown, so started the weekend really well, a good position to be in. The feedback from the drivers is there's some corners which are just about flat out, but we're going to find out tomorrow. So I think for the guys, it's a really, really enjoyable circuit to drive. We've seen that in the simulator. And yeah, we're really positive coming to this weekend. We've had a really great last couple of races. So we're really raring to go and give it our best shot this weekend.
Now, we're halfway through the season. Last year was a learning year for us. We faced many challenges. This has been a very different season. So can you just summarise how it's gone so far?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, Jaguar has a really illustrious history of motorsport, but it's our second year back after a long hiatus, a long time away from the sport. And last year was very much our learning year, but this year has been really exciting. We've hit the ground running with a really competitive car and a fantastic driver lineup. And both, you know, I think so far we've had a record number of fourth place finishes pretty much this year to date, but a very strong year. And without a doubt, we are a front runner in the championship now. From our perspective, we are within shot of the championship as well, with half the season gone. We're a team now which are coming to every race expecting and really driving to be on the podium, and we really feel within the team that a win isn't far away for us now. So to come to a racetrack every weekend knowing we're going to be in a shot to get points, not only points, to be on the podium, is a really positive time for us.
Of course, we're also here celebrating the debut of the I-Pace in Italy. It's very exciting that it's here parked outside as well. Talk to me a little bit about that technology transfer between what we're doing on the track and the road car.
Yeah, firstly, we were the first premium brand to come into Formula E. We kind of really want to take a brave step to come into this championship, which we felt was incredibly, it was the start of an incredible journey, I should say. And we're really pleased that we're also the first premium manufacturer to have a car available in the market from this summer with the new Jaguar I-Pace. So it's for us at Jaguar Land Rover, a really important product, arguably one of the most important cars ever. And what's really important with Formula E is not only is it a platform to tell the world that Jaguar is producing battery electric vehicles, but actually also the transfer of technology from the racetrack to the road, it is really real. We have a mission within the team, and that's called Race to Innovate. It's about racing to win and be successful. It's about innovating and taking that learning from the racetrack to the road, and it's about inspiring. It's about creating a racing team which kids look at and want to understand how they can have a career in the motor racing industry. So from our perspective, that's our team mission, but the technology transfer is absolutely real. And the components that we have in our race car and the learnings, they are already going into our next generation of Jaguar and Land Rover electric vehicles.
And finally, we've had a couple of weeks off since the last round in Punta del Este in Uruguay, but been a very busy time for the team as well, because of course it was the first debut for the Gen 2 car. Tell us about that.
Yes, from a Formula E perspective, the step change next year is a big one. Currently we have two cars for a 50-minute race, and the drivers change cars halfway through. For next season, we go to a car with a 50 kilowatt hour battery that lasts the full race distance. So it just shows you how quickly the technology is developing. And as you can see from the pictures, the car looks fantastic. It looks a bit like a Batmobile, people have said, but very striking, very different to anything you've seen before. And our first shakedown of the car is going really well. So in fact, we go straight from this weekend to our next test with the new car, with all the other manufacturers. So whilst we're racing here in season four, we're already developing our car for next year. So a busy time, but we can't wait to go racing with this new car as well.
James, thank you very much. Now, of course, as I mentioned, the last time we were out on track was in Uruguay, in the city of Punta del Este. Before the drivers come up and join me, let's just take a look at what happened there.
So I've been pretty confident for a race win today.
I had a broken drive shaft and they had to work very, very hard over here to get the car together for the race.
For Rome and for Paris, we go towards those races just really hunting for podiums now.
Would you please welcome onto the stage our two racing drivers, Mitch Evans and Nelson Piquet Jr. To start with you, just tell me reflections on Rome so far. Time out on the track earlier on today, how's it been?
Yeah, it's been great. It's my first time in Rome, so it's been a special time for me. See the Colosseum for the first time, everything's pretty cool. The circuit looks great and it felt pretty cool today. A lot of elevation change, looks super technical in some areas, so I think we've got a big challenge tomorrow, but it also looks like it's going to produce good racing, which is super important. So, I'm looking forward to tomorrow, but we'll see what happens.
Now, it's a new circuit to Formula E. It's also got more corners than any other track that we visited, so it's going to be a very difficult track to learn. How hard is it to learn, and how good is it then that all the teams are in the same boat, not just us?
Yeah, it's tough. The only preparation we've got is based on the simulator, which gives us a good sort of head start before we get to get on track for real life, and then it's just a matter of remembering all the corners. You know, racing drivers have got short memories, so to learn is not the easiest, but today was great to get on track, just to get a bit of a feel for the flow of it, what's sort of required for the car to be faster on here. So it was on quite a low power mode, but tomorrow we get to go on full power, and then we'll have a better indication.
Now, of course, last question. Punta del Este, there was a penalty for you because of the battery change and the infringement. You therefore started at the back. We all felt, I think you felt as well, that a podium was in our sights. Are you hopeful for here in Rome?
Yeah, I'm hopeful. To be honest, I think we could have won in Punta. I would have started off pole actually with all the other penalties, but even if I started off third in my original position, I think we could have fought for the win, so a definite podium as well. But so we go into this race with the podium as our target, and hopefully it can be a double podium. I think between Nelson and I, we're pretty strong in the races now, and it's just a matter of starting in a good position, and then I think from there we can leave it up to us and we'll finish off.
Sounds great. Mitch, thank you very much. Now Nelson, welcome to Rome, but of course you were here earlier on as well. You were part of the filming that took place earlier. What have your impressions been to be back?
Well, good afternoon everybody, or good night. Well, coming to Rome and Italy, it's always very special. It's a country that in many ways is very similar to Brazil. My dad always loved this country as much as he loves Brazil, so we have a lot of connections over here. The Italians, most of the Italians are all crazy like Brazilians, so I really love it over here. Not only the food, but the people are really fun. You know, I think it's probably one of my favorite countries to be in Europe. So not only that, but Rome is, I have never been in Rome before this year, and it's really, really amazing. I mean, the architecture and the history that it goes around here is, it's beyond what I could imagine, how amazing it is. I mean, not only the Colosseum, that's only 10% of it, but all the rest is just amazing, this place, how beautiful it is. So really proud to be able to race over here, and yeah, I can't wait to get started.
Okay, so give us your impressions of the circuit that you were on earlier on today and what you're looking forward to tomorrow.
I think this track is probably the best track I've been since season one, formerly, you know. We've been to tracks like this one, like for example Moscow. There was some big tracks, but this one is matching one of the best tracks by far. So I'm really, really excited. I mean, it's a big track, a lot of corners, a lot of elevation changes, you know, so yeah, it's probably for sure this year is gonna be the best track.
You talk about those elevation changes just quickly. How much does it take out of the battery? Because of course there is the big hill up, there's also the hill back down again. What's that like?
Well, I mean, it's the same for everybody, you know? I mean, it's, obviously we're gonna use more battery the way up and use less on the way down. That's a bit normal, but apart from that, it's just a very good track.
Finally, you've been out in the Gen 2 car. You were testing it earlier on. What's it like? Is it different? Are you looking forward to next year?
Yeah, the new Formula E car that we're gonna be using in season 5, starting December this year, it's a big step ahead. Obviously it's quicker, it looks better, obviously we're going to be racing longer with it. I mean, it's better in all aspects, you know, it looks much more aggressive. It's a really fun car. I think it's gonna make racing fun, even better than it is right now. So yeah, obviously it's very early stages of development, you know, there's still at least 5 months before we have our final spec of the car, but it's been great to be out in the car running.
Great stuff. Thank you very much, Nelson. Thank you very much, Mitch. Now, as I mentioned earlier, of course, this is Italy's first seeing of the I-Pace. The I-Pace has been very busy. Let's have a look at what Matt has been up to recently.
Amazing. looks really futuristic, and I think it's going to be a really exciting time for the brand.
That I'm joined by another very special guest, Jaguar's studio director, Wayne Burgess, is here to talk to me a little bit about the car. Wayne, come up. So Wayne, we're at the race team, we're very excited to be part of this technology transfer into the road car, but of course you've been responsible in the designing of that. What have the challenges been that you faced creating an all-new electric car?
Well, Amanda, the simple truth is that actually having an all-electric architecture to design around has been incredibly liberating for the design team. We've been able to remove all of those traditional building blocks, remove the internal combustion engine, remove the transmission, slide the cab forward, give the car a really sporty cab forward profile, and actually turn what started out as an electric SUV into a car that's much more like a mid-engine supercar in terms of its profile and its language. So we've been really excited by the opportunities rather than the challenges of electrification.
The funny thing about the car is that whilst it looks totally different to any other Jaguar that we've seen on the road, there is still so much Jaguar about it. How have you managed to sort of weave that in?
Now that probably has been more of a challenge because obviously electric vehicles are all about optimum aerodynamic performance, and we've worked so hard to make I-PACE as aerodynamically as efficient as possible. But we've put those details in there, those graphic elements that remind you that it is a Jaguar. The grille shape is still very familiar, although it works in a very different way on I-PACE. It actually channels air over the screen and reduces drag. Those headlamps with the four J blades, the quad lamp signature that's synonymous with Jaguar, that's there for everybody to see. And around the rear of the car, we've evolved the F-type tail lamp signature into something more modern with the chicane line. So those little graphic details that you see all over the car that remind you it's a Jaguar.
And since the car's first launch, there has been tremendous interest in it, hasn't it? I mean, the tour, if you like, that the I-PACE has been on has been incredibly well received. What's the reaction been?
Absolutely incredible. I mean, obviously, Ian, Callum, myself, the Jaguar First Line, we've already been all around the world with the car. I've been in Norway, where, frankly, in Oslo, the car was received like a rock star. It was like the Beatles arriving at an airport. I literally finished the presentation, stood back from the car, and hundreds of people descended on the vehicle. So the reception's been absolutely rapturous. I love the fact that the world has embraced the idea of an all-electric SUV Jaguar, which is so avant-garde, let's be honest, but they've totally gotten behind the idea and they've been really supportive.
Finally, you are partly responsible, you are responsible for the design of the beautiful Gen 2 car that we've been looking at earlier on. How exciting is that for you and your team to also be part of other projects within the Jaguar family?
Well, yeah, I mean, we apply the same philosophy to everything that we design, whether it's the team livery, whether it's the graphics that go onto our race cars, whether it's the bodywork on our road vehicles. We always have the same philosophy, which is make the purest statement you can with the best proportions, have a graphical simplicity to it. And in the case of the Season 2 car, the Generation 2 car, we've worked really hard, and this, by the way, is just the testing livery, so there's more to come. But we wanted to produce a really pure dynamic graphic statement with the lines that we put on the car. So that's been what's really interesting is about doing this.
Wayne, thank you very much.
Thank you, Amanda.
So again, on behalf of everybody in the team, I would like to say thank you so much for welcoming us to your beautiful city. We are really excited to be here. I'd now like to remind you that if you have the press badge, the media badge like this, to make your way upstairs. But that wraps up this part of the evening. So for me, and I say from everybody else, thank you very much. Have a wonderful evening. Good night.